If sine theta equals negative 5/7 and theta is in quadrant 3, we want to determine each trig function value. So to find these trig function values, we're going to model angle theta in the third quadrant, sketch the reference triangle for angle theta, then determine these trig function values. So if theta is in quadrant 3, that means the terminal side must be in this quadrant here. So we'll go ahead and assume that this would be the terminal side of the angle. Now the reference angle for angle theta would be the angle between the terminal side of the angle and the x-axis, or this angle here, which we'll call theta sub r. So to form the reference triangle, we'll sketch a segment from the terminal side that's perpendicular to the x-axis, so a segment that looks like this. And now because we know sine theta is equal to negative 5/7, that means the ratio of the opposite side to the hypotenuse must be negative 5/7. Remember, for reference triangles, the legs can be positive or negative, but the hypotenuse is always positive. So if sine theta is equal to negative 5/7, that means we can label the opposite side negative 5 and the hypotenuse 7. But in order to find these trig function values, we'll also have to find the length of this leg here. And we can do this using the Pythagorean theorem. So if we call this x, we know x squared plus negative 5 squared must equal 7 squared. So we have x squared plus 25 equals 49. Subtract 25 on both sides and we have x squared equals 24. And now we'll take the square root of both sides of the equation. Remember, x can be both positive and negative, so we have x equals plus or minus the square root of 24, but 24 is equal to 4 times 6, and since the square root of 4 is equal to 2, we have x equals plus or minus 2 square root 6. To determine the sine, remember we're in the third quadrant where the x coordinate and the y coordinate are both negative. Therefore, x is going to be equal to negative 2 square root 6. Now that we have all three sides of our reference triangle labeled, we can find these trig function values. Cosine theta will be equal to the ratio of the adjacent side to the hypotenuse, which would be negative 2 square root 6 over 7. The secant of theta will be equal to the ratio of the hypotenuse to the adjacent side, which would be 7 divided by negative 2 square root 6. So we have negative 7 over 2 square root 6. But we're often asked to rationalize the denominators of these values. So let's go ahead and show how we would do that. If we have negative 7 all over 2 square root 6, if we want our denominator to be rational, we don't want the square root 6 here, so we'd have to multiply by the square root of 6 over the square root of 6. So we'll have negative 7 square root 6. In the denominator, we'd have the square root of 6 times square root of 6 is 6 times 2, so that's 12. So we have negative 7 square root 6 divided by 12. Now the cosecant function value is equal to the reciprocal of the sine function value. So if the sine function value is negative 5 over 7, then the cosecant function value would be negative 7 over 5. Or using our reference triangle, it would be the ratio of the hypotenuse to the opposite side, or 7 divided by negative 5, giving us negative 7/5. And now for the tangent of theta, this will be the ratio of the opposite side to the hypotenuse, which would be negative 5
divided by negative 2 square root 6.
And since a negative divided by a negative is positive, we would have 5 divided by 2 square root 6. But again, let's go ahead and rationalize the denominator. If we have 5 divided by 2 square root 6, to eliminate the square root of 6 in the denominator, we'd multiply by the square root of 6 over the square root of 6. So we'll have 5 square root 6 all over, again, square root 6 times square root 6 is 6 times 2, that would be 12. So we have 5 square root 6 divided by 12. And then for the cotangent function value, since cotangent is equal to the reciprocal of tangent, we can use the reciprocal of this fraction here to find the cotangent of theta. It would be 2 square root 6 divided by 5. or using the reference triangle, it would be equal to the ratio of the adjacent side to the opposite side, or negative 2 square root 6 divided by negative 5, which would be positive 2 square root 6 over 5. So when given a problem like this, we always want to model the angle and the reference triangle to determine additional trig function values. I hope this was helpful.